8 minutes now before the hour, to the Star of Bethlehem. The Christians, a miraculous sign from God marking the birth of Jesus Christ. That was the star, they say, that led the three kings to Bethlehem. Scholars have debated the existence of it since, and now a professor says he's got the proof that the Star of Bethlehem did indeed exist. The professor behind it all, at the University of Notre Dame, Dr. Grant Matthews. Doctor, good morning to you. What's the proof that you have? What do you say happened some 2,000 plus years ago in the stars above?
Good morning, but really, there is no proof. I mean, no one knows for sure what the Star of Bethlehem is. It's just something that I and a lot of people have researched over the years. The prevailing view has been an alignment of planets that would have had a particular message to the Magi, and that remains valid. What I've done that's new a little bit is also to look at the possibility that there was an astrophysical event associated with this star.
And that would have been what? A nova, a supernova, a comet?
Well, as an astrophysicist, the things that most intrigue me would be a nova or a supernova, because they're the kind of events that would make a bright star in the sky that would suddenly appear and seem to be there for a while and possibly in the culture of the time herald the introduction of a new regime.
Let me stop you there a moment, because you went on to say that you have Arab and Chinese astrology that contributes to your theory. How does that work into this?
Well, the Chinese and Korean astronomers kept very careful records of events they saw in the sky, and in about that time frame, from about 1 to 8 BC, I scanned through their records, and there was an event in the constellation Aquila, which showed up in about 4 BC, which is more or less the right time frame of when we think Christ was born, which would have been the time for the
stars. So this is what, Doctor, this is what I'm imagining is the night sky. You're out there in the desert, and if this thing appears, it would certainly provide an awful lot of illumination for anyone to go toward it or see where they're going.
Well, it probably actually wasn't that bright. Let me say, what I've done is scan the NASA databases to see, well, was there a nova or a supernova that would have likely erupted about 2,000 years ago? We're in a special time frame in astronomy now, because we can, in principle, see almost any star in the galaxy, so we have a good chance of finding it. There is one or two supernova remnants with about the right age. One in particular is in Aquila, and it's about 2,000 years old. Its name is Kestevan 75.
Well, you've done your research. Doctor, thank you. I wanted to bring that into
the number one best real war on Christmas. Australian astronomer Dave Renicky. London's newspaper The Telegraph quoting him saying new computer technology permits him and his colleagues to recreate any night sky of the last several thousand years. And by comparing the so-called Christmas star with astronomical history, they have concluded that if it really happened, it wasn't just hyperbole. What people would have seen above Jerusalem was the conjunction of the planets Venus and Jupiter, so close that night that they would have seemed like one giant star. Thus, the conjunction, the Christmas star, and the night of the birth of Jesus, all in the year 2 BC. On the 17th of June.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.